As the only two series from the TV arm of the comic giant still left on the streamer, there will be no season 3 of the John Bernthal-led Vigilante series. I've Learned. The completed third season of the Chris and Ritter starring Jessica Jones will still appear on the streamer but will be put on ice for good after that. This marks the end of the multi-series, Big Bucks and Big Ambitions relationship between Marvel and Flix that started in 2013 with the announcement of four series and the Defenders limited series. Marvel's The Punisher will not return for a third season on Netflix, Netflix confirmed today to Deadline. Showrunner Steve Lightfoot, the terrific crew, and exceptional cast including star John Bernthal, delivered an acclaimed and compelling series for fans, and we are proud to showcase their work on Netflix for years to come, the streamer added. In addition, in reviewing our Marvel programming, we have decided that the upcoming third season will also be the final season for Marvel's Jessica Jones. Netflix also made official this President's Day. We are grateful to showrunner Melissa Rosenberg, star Chris and Ritter and the entire cast and crew, for three incredible seasons of this groundbreaking series, which was recognized by the Peabody Awards among many others. We are grateful to Marvel for 5 years of our fruitful partnership and thank the passionate fans who have followed these series from the beginning. The Jeff Loeb-led Marvel TV issued their own words of celebration and farewell after Deadline exclusively broke the news of the dual cancellation, with a kicker shout out to Daredevil, the first of the Marvel series to air on Netflix on April 10, 2015. It had never been done before. Four separate television series, each with different super talented showrunners, writers, directors, cast and crew, coming out months apart and then they would meet in a single event series all set in the heart of New York City. We called them the Defenders and together we were thrilled by stories of Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, Iron Fist and even the Punisher joined in. They said it couldn't be done. But Marvel assembled amazing teams to write, produce, direct, edit, and score 13 seasons and 161 one-hour episodes. Take a moment and go online and look at the dazzling list of actors, writers, directors, and musicians who graced us with the very best of their craft. We loved each and every minute of it. And we did it all for you, the fans who cheered for us around the world and made all the hard work worth it. On behalf of everyone at Marvel Television, we couldn't be more proud or more grateful to our audience. Our network partner may have decided they no longer want to continue telling the tales of these great characters, but you know Marvel better than that, the company added. As Matthew Murdock's dad once said, "The measure of a man is not how he gets knocked to the mat, it's how he gets back up." To be continued. Though the decision not to bring Punisher back for more has been rumored for weeks, Netflix and Marvel waited until after the January 18th debuting 13-episode season 2 had been on the streamer for several weeks before making the cancellation official. The end of Jones comes as more of a shocker, though I hear the end of the upcoming third and final season will serve as a savory series finale. The news of the end of Punisher and Jessica Jones follows the revelation that Walking Dead Alan Bernthal is set to join New Line's The Sopranos prequel feature, which currently has the working title of The Many Saints of Newark. In part it was because of new roles and new work like The Sopranos pick, the streamer didn't want to have the creators and cast for either show hanging on waiting for renewals that clearly weren't in the cards. Bernthal took to social media this morning to offer a cryptic farewell of sorts,